So imagine that every time you get and use FM products, you earn money. Isn't it fantastic?
Yeah. Yes.
So welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Marcin. I've got the privilege to have the product presentation here. So I hope that I'll show you and I'll tell you about the benefits of the product, because I think this is really important if you deal with MLM company, to know the products, to know what you use, and to know what you recommend to other people. So first of all, just a brief picture of all of the products that we've got. So basically, on the first place, we've got perfume. Perfume and body care products. So that's the first line of products, and the company basically started from perfume, later from body care products. On the other place, we've got makeup products. The makeup is mineral. And the last place, household products. So briefly, I'm gonna tell you about each of the products. I'll tell you about the benefits of the products and how to use them, because this is, especially if it comes to household products, it's very important the proper way to use the products. Otherwise, they're not gonna be effective. So first of all, world of perfume. Maybe a little bit about history. This is something interesting. At first, perfume came as a smoke. Actually, our ancestors, they used different resins and gums. They produced the smoke, and along with the smoke, they put some gifts for their gods, and they wanted to be accepted. So that's where the word perfume comes from. It comes from the Latin word perfumum, which means through smoke. So nowadays, we can speak about a huge perfume industry, which involves many, many people, also psychologists, who design different tests in order to satisfy the customers. The main cities which are very famous for perfume are Paris, Graz, and nowadays, of course, Nizden, right? In England, actually, perfume industry developed thanks to Elizabeth I, who brought the perfume into England from France, and she loved them. In the past, people used to spray perfume in many different things, not only on their body, but also on furniture, on pets, on things like that. So, now, there are many different brands of perfume on the market, and there are many different laboratories who specialize in producing the different fragrance compositions. So FM company, as you know, cooperates with Drom company, which is a German company. This company has been already run by the third generation. It is located not far from Munich. They produce basically fragrance compositions for many different brands and also for FM. The company has very high-tech specialized laboratories on every continent, in Europe, Far East, Middle East, Australia, and both Americas. It is very difficult to create a particular fragrance. A basic bottle of perfume consists of 40 to 100 different ingredients. The one that we sell, they consist of sometimes 200 and 300 ingredients. So it's very, very difficult to do that. That's why all of the companies, including FM, use high-tech laboratories in order to produce the fragrance compositions. Because you need a real professional scientist, which are called noses, to be able to create a nice fragrance. So what kind of perfume have we got on our offer? So first of all, there is a classic collection for ladies. Classic collection contains 20% of the fragrance oil, which makes this fragrance perfume. So whatever perfume contains less than 20% of the fragrance oil is considered to be eau de perfume. If a bottle of fragrance contains even less than 16%, it is considered to be eau de toilette. So basically, on the market, you can find mostly eau de perfume and eau de toilettes, not real perfume. They call this perfume because that's easier, but they are perfume and eau de toilettes. So here in FM, for ladies, we have mostly perfume because they contain 20% of the fragrance oil, and also we can offer eau de toilettes. All the classic fragrances, it is very important, they come in the same boxes, in the same bottles, but we can distinguish them by numbers. So every bottle has a number, so each fragrance is different. Our brand is FM, which stands for Federico Mahora. So all the perfume are by FM. So to be easier to recognize different fragrances, we just indicate them by numbers. We also have hot collection for ladies. There are selected number of classic collection which come in hot collection. And what's hot collection? Hot collection contains 30% of the fragrance oil if it comes to perfume for ladies. Of course, on our offer we've got perfume and other perfume for men. All the classic collection, that's other perfume. It means they contain minimum 16% of the fragrance oil inside. However, you can find a hot collection for men as well, which is really, really extraordinary, because I'm sure that if you go somewhere to a shop and you ask for a perfume for men, you can get it. So here you can, as the hot collection for men contains 24% of the fragrance oil. And one more thing, we also have pheromone collection for men and ladies, and also some selected numbers of the classic collection come in pheromone collection. So I'm sure that you know what pheromones are. So they're scentless substances. You can't really detect using your own nose, but they can be detected by your subconscious mind. So basically when people use pheromone perfume, what they say, and actually this is from our customers' experience, they feel more self-confident, their mood improves, they notice that they've got better relations with their business partners, for instance. So let's say before you go and speak to any prospects, I recommend to use the pheromone collection. It's gonna be easier to communicate. And one more thing, if somebody asks you, where do we get pheromones from? You can say we get pheromones from truffles mushroom. Because normally people, animals, they produce pheromones by themselves. This is a natural body substance. So obviously we don't get that from animals or people, we just get it from truffles mushroom. And we also have luxury collection for men and ladies. Mostly luxury collection for ladies are considered to be perfume, 20% of the fragrance oil. Most of the bottles are different. And the same, it looks for men. So most of the bottles are different. Some of them are the same. However, only two fragrances for men in luxury collection, they're considered to be perfume because they contain 20% of the fragrance oil, and the numbers are 300 and 198. The rest of the luxury collection for men are other perfume. Okay. Perfume notes. It happens many times that we've got some customers, they come to the shop, they spray a particular fragrance and they say, okay, I like it. Or let's say, no, I don't like it. And then after a while, they say, no, it's nice. I thought it wasn't nice, but now it's nice. That happens because a particular perfume has different phases, and the phases are called notes. And why is that? As I said, inside a bottle we've got many different ingredients. Some of them are naturally stronger, some of them are naturally weaker. And of course, the ingredients evaporate as the time goes. So some of them evaporate faster, some of them evaporate slower. So that's why the particular fragrance changes over time. So the first note, when you spray your perfume, the first scent is called the head note. So it lasts up to 1-2 minutes. And usually it is not recommended to smell the perfume straight away, just after a couple of seconds, because the first smell that you can detect is in fact the alcohol smell. Because perfume, they contain alcohol and fragrance oils. So that makes the scent last for a long time. So you have to wait for the alcohol to evaporate first, and then you can detect the head note. Normally the head note, it's not really, really pleasant. It depends on the perfume. Then, when the head note evaporates, at the departure of the head note, the heart note appears. So this note is more mellow, more round. So basically it's a bit deeper and it lasts for a longer time, usually up to 1 or 2 hours. Then the base note appears. So the base notes consist a very heavy molecules. The molecules evaporate very slowly, so the scent of the base note might last even up to 24 hours or longer. So that's why you have to understand that the smell of the perfume changes over time, and that is because of the perfume notes. What is important when you select your perfume? There are a few things I think that should be considered. First of all, you have to understand the different types of perfumes. So at the end of our catalogs, you can find a table with fragrance families. And that will help you to identify which fragrance might be good for you. Whether it's something citrusy, something more oriental, or something watery, or flowery, fruity. So once you identify what kind of fragrances you or your customer like, you can choose a particular number, and then you can select the good one for you. Some people like something more spicy, some people like something more subtle. In this way, you can identify the good fragrance. Then you have to pick a perfume type appropriate for your setting. And that is because different fragrances, they've got different strengths. So I would recommend to use different fragrances, let's say if you go to work, and different fragrances if you go out. So let's say if you work in a closed space with other people somewhere in an office, you just spray a very, very strong perfume, and then your nose adjusts to this scent and you stop smelling the perfume after a while. But it doesn't mean that people around you, they stop smelling the fragrance too. They still smell it. And then when you stop smelling, you tend to reapply the perfume. So the scent for other people is overpowering. So you must be aware of that, that your nose adjusts to the perfume. So resist the urge to reapply the fragrance. And choose the good one for your setting. So if you go to work, choose something more subtle. If you go out, you can choose something stronger, as you're going to be out for a longer time, and actually there will be definitely more space than at your workplace. before wearing it. And let's say there's a perfume 110 which I like. So when I spray the perfume 110 on myself, it might smell differently than on Gediminas, let's say. Because our skin is different, we produce different, our skin produces different things, different oils, that there's a slightly different pH, so the smell of 110 might be different on my skin and on Gediminas' skin, right? So it is very important to test it on yourself, and then if after a while you still like it, okay, go for it. But don't just get the perfume because somebody else got it or because it smells nice on someone else. Just choose a particular fragrance just for yourself. Limit how many scents you test at once. It's that what I said before. After a while, our nose stops detecting fragrances. So when you smell 2, 3, or 4 perfumes at once, it's okay. But then just give yourself time. You can smell coffee beans or tea bag just to neutralize the scent of perfumes, and then start smelling different fragrances. Sometimes at the distributor center, we've got some customers, and they come to the shop, they spray the perfume on themselves, and they smell constantly for 1-2 minutes. And then they say, it's gone, the fragrance is gone. But actually, I smelled their hand, no, I can still smell it, but I can't. Because their nose just adjusted to that scent. So there are two ways. When you smell the perfumes, on and on and on, or you smell so many perfumes at once, first of all, you might stop smelling the fragrances whatsoever, or everything might smell the same. So up to 3 or 4 fragrances at once, then a short break, then you can start smelling them again. Can I just take some water?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry about that. My throat is very dry. Yesterday I had a training. I was speaking for 3 hours. Okay, so before application, when you apply perfume, it is very important. Everybody wants the perfume last for a long time. So when you want that, first of all, the perfume will last for longer time if you apply that after taking a bath or shower. Secondly, the more moisturized your skin is, the longer the fragrance is going to stay on your skin. So you should apply a body lotion before applying a perfume. So we've got different perfumes and body lotion and shower gels which have the same numbers. So then you can select a particular shower gel or body lotion to have the same fragrance. If we haven't got a particular shower gel or body lotion which you can match with the perfume, you can just select a body lotion which comes from the same fragrance family. Don't use shower gels, let's say flower shower gels or fruity shower gels, if you are going to apply musky fragrance, because the fragrances are going to clash. And the smell of the perfume is going to be different. So try to avoid that, clashing fragrances. And how to apply the perfume? This is important as well, because if you want the perfume last for a long time, you should apply the perfume in particular areas. So first of all, the best idea is to spray the perfume on your pulse points, so which are your wrists, the inner part of your elbow, behind your ears, over your neck and throat area, on your chest, and even ladies can apply behind their knees. And the rule is, pulse points are usually warmer, so the the blood flows stronger, so the fragrance is gonna last longer. But on our body, we've got some points, like for instance behind our ears or inner part of the elbow. These points are usually more moist than your wrists, let's say. So when you spray the perfume on that sort of points, then definitely the perfume will last longer, but it's not gonna be that strong at first. So you've got a choice. If you want the perfume last longer, spray the naturally moist areas, elbows, behind your ears. If you want the perfume to be powerful from the very beginning, spray the pulse points. So your wrists, throat area here, or chest. Spray the perfume from a distance of 5 to 6 inches. People tend to spray the perfume from a very close distance. So then you've got the alcohol on your hand. The alcohol will evaporate slowly. It might irritate your skin. And the fragrance might not last long. If you spray and you keep the 5 or 6 inch distance, the alcohol will evaporate quickly and the fragrance oil will stay on your skin for a longer time. Avoid rubbing the perfume into your skin. So, have you ever seen people trying perfume and rubbing like this and then smelling or even here? So it's not a good idea. Why? First of all, as I said, each bottle of perfume contains alcohol. So when you rub the alcohol into your skin and you've got very sensitive skin, then your skin might get irritated. Secondly, as I said, perfume contains molecules, and molecules are usually round, so they make the fragrance smell nice. So when you rub that, you crush the molecules. It means the fragrance is not gonna last long, and it might even completely change. So don't rub. And some tips: when you store your perfume, try to keep your perfume out of the direct sunlight. As we said, it's alcohol inside. When the alcohol is locked in a bottle, then the light will cause some pressure inside the bottle. So first of all, the alcohol might evaporate. So then after a while, the bottle might be empty, even if you didn't use it. Secondly, it might even explode if the pressure becomes too strong, too high. Resist the urge to reapply. So that's what I said. Don't tend to reapply. It's better to ask somebody, can you still smell the perfume? If yes, okay, that's fine. So you don't need to reapply. If not, okay, you can try to reapply the perfume. But some of the strong fragrances, like for instance 21, definitely they will last for up to 24 hours. And these are our best sellers so far. And these best sellers are in the UK. So the list of top 10 fragrances varies from country to country. So in the UK, from the classic collection for ladies, number 18 has been a bestseller for a very long time. For men, 110. Whereas from the luxury collection for ladies, 313. And for men, 199. Okay. At first, I said that you have to understand a difference between different fragrances, the family groups. But here, I was trying to prepare a kind of comparison between different fragrances. So let's say strong fragrances for confident ladies. So I didn't use the family division. I just used my sense of smell to select strong or slightly weaker fragrances, something that you can wear when you go, let's say, to the gym, when you go running, or during the summertime, springtime. So let's have a look. I'm not sure if you are going to agree with me or not, but I think the strong fragrances for confident ladies, from Classic Collection is number 5, 21 and 263. You've got your starter kits with samples, so later you can test it yourself and we'll see if we've got the same opinion on that. If it comes to Luxury Collection, I selected 286, 352 and 356. In my opinion, those ones are one of the strongest that we've got on our offer. Subtle fragrances for charming ladies. So if if somebody doesn't want something really strong, you can recommend them number 12 from Classic Collection, 97 or 271. From Luxury Collection, I selected 293, 317 and 354. They're quite subtle, quite nice. And what do you have to remember? Another thing. These fragrances are naturally strong, so it means they contain very strong ingredients. These are more subtle. Some people say, this perfume disappears, the fragrance disappears so quickly. So I'm not sure if there is 20% of the fragrance oil inside. I can assure you that there is. Some of the fragrances might disappear and might last slightly shorter than other fragrances. However, they contain 20% of the fragrance oil inside, or even more if it comes to Hot Collection. The reason some of them might disappear faster are the ingredients. So, musky fragrances, oriental fragrances, they're usually stronger, so naturally they last longer. If you use citrusy fragrances or watery fragrances, some of the flowery ones, definitely they're going to last a bit shorter because they're not so intense. Okay, energetic fragrances for sporty ladies. So that's what I selected. Number 6, number 80 and number 400. Definitely they are very, very fresh. And from Luxury Collection, 309, 321 and 351. And the last point, ideal spring fragrances for modern ladies. So I think it's gonna be something interesting. Number 15, 81, 185, and from Luxury Collection, 74. This is from the Flower Collection, 74, 281, and 318. Because Flower Collection belongs to Luxury Collection. However, it is slightly less expensive than Luxury Collection and more expensive than the Classic Collection. So it's something in between, but that's Luxury Collection. Okay. That's for ladies. So how about men? So strong fragrances for confident men. Definitely from Classic Collection, 189, 51 and 56. They're really strong fragrances. From Luxury Collection, 152, 198 and 327. Another category that I was thinking about was subtle fragrances for seductive men.
I believe the 110 is here.
Okay, 45 from Classic, 55 and 110.
That's awesome.
Yes, that's what you thought. And Luxury, 155, 195 and 330. Okay. Is there any fragrance that is anybody's favorite? Which one?
110.
110. Okay. Yeah, the same.
Can you not be confident and seductive at the same time?
It's pretty bold.
Mixture.
Yes, but make sure that they belong to the same fragrance family. Okay, energetic fragrances for active men. 63, 93, 135 and 158, 300 and 324. They are really citrusy, very refreshing. So normally they will last slightly shorter compared to the strong family group. Okay, and ideal spring fragrances for masculine men? Definitely 68, 134, and 351, and from the luxury collection 160, 325, and 331. It's almost like bingo. Okay, so can we move on?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So that's about perfume world. Now, world of body care products. In FM, we've got quite a huge range of body care products. We don't really have time here to discuss all of them.
How much time is it?
It's just half an hour.
Okay. So I'm gonna speak about two of them from the Beta Glucan collection. The first product is the face serum. This product was voted number one in Poland if it comes to body care products by ladies who sent text messages to one of the magazines over there. So from many different brands of body care products, this product was voted number one. And there are a few reasons for that. First of all, the whole beta-glucan collection contains beta-glucan, which comes from oats. There are many benefits of beta-glucan. The main one could be beta-glucan definitely is anti-aging. Secondly, it provides natural UV filter. So when you use the creams, you can protect your skin against external factors, especially sun rays. Also, the beta-glucan increases immunity of the skin. And it regenerates the skin and also provides proper moisture. The face serum contains, of course, beta-glucan and colloidal silver. Colloidal silver is considered to be a natural antibiotic, so the face serum can be used by people with problematic skin, with acne-prone, atopic inflammation, spot-prone. Definitely, it's gonna help to soothe the irritation and get rid of red spots, and it's gonna heal the inflamed skin as well. It contains omega 3, 6, and 9. They are fatty acids. They nourish your skin and moisturize your skin as well. Coconut oil is antibacterial, so when some people got some spots or acne, it's definitely the product for them, as the coconut oil is gonna soothe the irritation, and there's a less risk of any bacterial inflammation as well. The other thing is the vitamin C, which is considered a natural antioxidant, so it means that the aging process of your skin is going to be slowed down. The other product is anti-cellulite body lotion. This body lotion contains anti-cellulite forte complex, and that's why it will help to reduce or completely get rid of the cellulite. Secondly, thanks to the ingredients it contains, it's gonna prevent stretch marks. So let's say women who are going to be pregnant, they can use that before, during, and after pregnancy, because it's safe for them and it's safe for the child, and they can prevent the stretch marks. The other advantage of this anti-cellulite body balm is that it helps to speed up to burn fat. So let's say, if you are going to the gym, you want to lose weight, you can use this, and it will help you to burn fat. Why? Because it contains caffeine from guarana, which in a natural way helps to burn fat. So I think the beta-glucan basically is an amazing collection. You can read something more about the ingredients and benefits in the catalogs. The other skin care products are the Skin Lab for Men and also the BodyCyle collection for ladies. Basically, they contain similar ingredients. The ingredients are all natural. 98% of the ingredients are natural, out of which 60% come from organic farming. This collection doesn't contain any parabens, any artificial coloring, any glycols or silicones, nothing like that. No chemicals which might irritate your skin. So you can use the soap even to wash your face because it's natural. There's nothing artificial, no color, no artificial coloring or smelling. By the way, the soap is handmade. It's really high quality, and it contains vitamin E, which naturally moisturizes your skin and protects the natural lipid layer of your skin. So it cleans, but on the other hand, it looks after your skin. Here, actually, we've got two different body creams. The one on the right-hand side, the brown one, is body cream for men, and the other one is body mousse for ladies. They are really, really good, but I would recommend that to dry skin, because they are quite oily. They contain avocado oil, coconut oil, so they really moisturize your skin and oil your skin at the same time. So if somebody has really, really dry skin, those products are definitely for them. With this collection, also come hot body butter, and for men, face mattifying face cream, for ladies, sugar body scrub. And layering. Here, I'm going to just speak briefly about the layering. Have you ever heard about layering if it comes to perfume? Yes. So basically, layering is the idea of using products, at least three, which smell the same. I said that if you use different products from different family groups, if it comes to fragrances, the molecules are gonna crash. But if you want the smell to last longer, you should use the products from the same family group, and that is called layering. So, for instance, from the classic collection, you can select a perfume, you can select a body lotion, you can select hand and nail cream, roll-on, and hairspray. Maybe briefly about the hairspray and the roll-on. If it comes to the hairspray, it's nothing that you can use to style your hair, but you can use this product to look after your hair. As it contains provitamin B5, which is really good for your hair, it will give shine and volume to your hair, and what's more, it has a fragrance of a perfume, so your hair will smell nice. In FM, we also have roll-ons, and this is one thing that I'm gonna mention. All the roll-ons are antiperspirant, so it means they regulate the glands which are responsible for sweat. They don't block the glands, but just regulate overreacting glands. We have many different fragrances, but also for some people who are allergic to fragrances, we've got unisex roll-ons which are fragrance-free. However, if you speak to your customers, you have to find out if they are not allergic to aluminium, because aluminium is the main ingredient of the antiperspirants. Thanks to that, the deodorant is antiperspirant. So if somebody is allergic to aluminium, they can't use our roll-ons. Okay. And now food care products. this is a fantastic range of food care products, four different products. First of all, let's start from the scrap. When you use the scrap on...
Okay, it's food care. We have to tell you.
Oh, sorry. Yes. Yeah. Yes. I'm not going to correct it right now. Yes, so first of all, the scrap. When you use the scrap on the regular basis, definitely it's going to help to soften the skin. It's gonna help to get rid of the dead cells of the skin. Also, it is anti-inflammatory. Then we have two different other products, deep moisturizing cream and the refreshing food gel. You can use the cream or the gel. Don't use two products at the same time because it doesn't make sense. The deep moisturizing cream is going to refresh your feet, soften the skin as well, and when you use that regularly, your feet are going to feel much, much lighter. And the soothing refreshing gel. The soothing refreshing gel is for tired feet. You can use that not only on your feet, but also you can put it a bit upper to your calves or even thighs. And it has anti-inflammatory properties. Definitely, it's going to reduce swelling. And it has anti-fungal properties as well. So you can use that, let's say, after you've gone to the swimming pool, just to make sure that your feet are thoroughly cleansed and protected. And the last product is antiperspirant. So definitely, it's going to help to calm down overreacted glands, which are responsible for sweating. Also, it's going to help to get rid of unpleasant odor. If you want, you can use this spray even to put inside your shoes, just to give a little bit of refreshment. Sorry about the mistake. Okay, if there is anything else, just let me know. Okay, and the world of makeup. Before, I will describe a few of our makeup products. It is very important to say that Avène makeup is 100% mineral. And what does it mean? It means that it contains mineral ingredients, nothing artificial. The mineral ingredients are zinc oxide inside the makeup products. However, those ones are the basic ones. All the minerals were pervolized, so they've got a form of powder, and sterilized as well. And what does it mean for you as a user of a mineral makeup? First of all, mineral makeup doesn't block pores. So even if you apply 2, 3, or 4 layers of the makeup, your skin is gonna breathe normally. Secondly, the minerals provide natural UV filter, so when you use mineral makeup, it will also look after your skin. It will even boost the health of your skin. It doesn't irritate skin. It's very soothing. Basically, mineral makeup was invented in the 50s of the last century, and it was designed for ladies who were subjected to plastic surgeries. So that was the reason for creating mineral makeup. Because we can distinguish two different makeups. It can be normal, chemically based makeup, and mineral makeup. So ladies, they couldn't use the chemical makeup, as it was really irritating for their skin, even for a normal skin, not after a plastic surgery. So somebody created a mineral makeup. It was really, really expensive at that time. So ladies after plastic surgeries, they could cover their skin imperfections, the scars and the swollen skin. And also it helped to cure the wounds after the plastic surgery. So when you use mineral makeup, definitely, if you've got problematic skin, with broken capillaries, for instance, or with acne, some red spots, and things like that, definitely it's gonna provide good coverage, and it's gonna heal the irritated skin as well. So that's, yes. And because it's mineral, the risk of allergy is really, really low. Somebody might get allergic to mineral makeup if the person is already allergic to some of the minerals which can be found in our environment. Otherwise, 99% the makeup won't cause any allergy.
Awesome. Sorry. Is it are the foundations mineral?
Yes. All the foundations are mineral. Yeah. Yeah. The whole makeup. Eyeshadows, foundation, powders, they're all mineral. Because it's mineral, it sort of blends with your skin, so your skin feels and looks very natural. And it's perfect for women suffering, for instance, from dryness, rosacea, and other skin disorders. As I said, it can be even used by ladies with atopic inflammation. And how to apply makeup? Surprisingly, I think many ladies, they're not really sure about which products to use and what is the correct order of makeup application. So I participated in the makeup days organized by FM, and I spoke to the makeup artists, so I can tell you that from the theoretical point of view, I can't do it practically, but I can just give you a hint in what way you can apply makeup. I'm going to point out some products. Of course, you don't need to use all of the products at once, but even if you remove one or two or three products, anyway, the order is still going to be in place. It's still going to be okay. So, first of all, before you apply makeup, it is very important to clean your skin. So, we've got a makeup remover, but you can use this micellar lotion also to clean your skin properly. Okay, a few words about the micellar lotion. You can use that before application of your makeup and after if you want to remove it. It's gonna remove even the waterproof makeup. It's very gentle, it doesn't contain alcohol, it contains micellars, which are round particles. They can be mixed with water, and that's why they absorb dirt and fat. So you can use that to clean your face, because during the day the dirt, the dust accumulates on your skin. So you want to provide to your skin a proper cleansing. Once your skin is fully cleansed, it's a good idea to apply a moisturizer or a semi-rich cream, depending on your skin type. You can use a face serum as well. You can use the face serum on its own, or you can wait until full absorption, and then you can use one of the creams. So if you've got very dry skin, you can use the semi-rich or rich cream. If you've got oily skin, it is a better idea to use a moisturizer. Then, when your skin is fully moisturized, you can apply a silicone base. If you've got a normal skin type, you can use the silicone base straight away after you clean your face. Silicone base will cover enlarged pores, minor wrinkles, and any other skin imperfections. It's completely transparent, so it can be used by people with any skin color and any skin type. Another product is eyeshadow base. You can use this over your eyelids. It will make the eyeshadows that you apply later on stay longer on your eyes. Then there is a concealer. Here is a dark skin concealer. We also have light skin concealers. And when you use that, you can just cover any skin imperfections. And you can use the concealer after or before application of foundation. We have many different type of foundations for dark and light skin. Some of them guarantee more coverage, some of them will blend with your skin type. The formula is called water in silicone, and it means that the foundation is really, really light, and when you blend it with your skin, it's gonna be almost invisible and very, very light for your skin. And there was one recommendation: when you apply foundation, it is a good idea to put it first on your hand or on the wrist, just to warm it up, so the temperature of foundation will adjust to your skin temperature, and then apply on your face. Then you can make sure that the foundation will blend with your skin perfectly. After the foundation, you can apply eyeshadows. All the eyeshadows in FM are mineral. Some of them are pressed, some of them are loose. The loose ones are usually glittering. Most of the pressed ones are just slightly glittering, or the cashmere eyeshadows that are completely matte. Then you can put the eye pencil. We've got many different colors. At the end of the eye pencil, there is a sharpener, so you can sharpen the pencil in order to draw very precise thick or thin lines that are enriched in natural oils and herbal extracts. And all of the eye pencils are waterproof, but you can remove them with the micellar lotion. Another thing is mascara. We have three different types of mascaras depending what kind of effect you would like to get. Here is the three-step mascara with a maybe strangely looking brush, but thanks to that you can cover even the shortest lashes. And what is the way to apply mascara? What I found out, the best way is the zigzag mode. So when you apply that, don't apply that like this, just apply that using a zigzag. That's what I found out from the beauticians and makeup artists, that this is the best way to cover your lashes.
Oh, I've been doing it wrong.
Yeah. Okay. Another thing that you can apply in order to mattify and set your makeup is the powder. Pressed powder. We have pressed powders and loose powders. Normally, pressed powders are a little bit heavier than loose powders. However, they will stay much, much longer on the skin and will mattify the skin. All the powders, they contain natural UV filters, and they regulate production of sebum. So it means that your skin and your makeup will stay fresh for a longer time. Then lips. Before you apply your lipstick, it is important to prepare your lips to apply the lipstick. As if your lips are dehydrated, they tend to chap, and the lipstick is not going to look nicely. So you can use the sugar lip scrub to exfoliate your lips. And then you must remember that when you exfoliate your lips tend to get dehydrated, because you just scrubbed the dead cells from your lips. So you have to use a lip balm or one of the lip gels in order to provide a proper moisture. Once you do that, you can apply it, you can apply a lip liner. And okay, lip liners, they are waterproof. This is another product which is waterproof. Some ladies say that okay, it's not fashionable to use lip liners nowadays, but in fact, when you use a lip liner, which you can match with a lipstick, then you can paint your lips, you can put the lipstick, and you can make a nice contours of your lips. You can't do it just using a lipstick, but you can do it when you apply the lip liner. So after the lip liner, you can apply a blush. So with a blush, you can shape your face. So usually the blush should be applied slightly over the cheek or over the apple that you can see, and up. So in this way, you will emphasize the cheeks, so your face will look beautiful. And then, to set the whole makeup, you can use the fixing powder. The fixing powder is white, but in fact, when you use a brush and you apply the fixing powder over the whole makeup that you've made, it's gonna set the makeup, and the color, the white color, is not gonna be visible. It's just to your skin color. So it doesn't matter if you've got dark or light skin, it's gonna blend with your skin color. And the last thing is the lipstick. Because when you apply the fixing powder, actually, it's a good idea to apply the lipstick as the last thing. And the last range of products are home products. Can I just very dry in my throat? Okay, so just briefly about home products. First of all, MLM company has to have much better products than the competition. Okay, why even home products are better than other products? The main reason is because some of them contain nanoparticles. And what are nanoparticles? Nanoparticles are small particles which build a protective layer over clean surfaces. So nanotechnology has been used in some of the products. They protect the surface. So when you clean the surface on the regular basis using the products, the surface is fully protected. It means that the dirt is not going to settle on the furniture, but it's going to settle on the protective surface. The protective surface is going to be invisible. However, you can see that straight away when it is created. I'll explain that in a second. Another thing why FM products are better than other products is because they contain special cleaning compounds. The cleaning compounds are responsible for removing dirt. The concentration of the cleaning compounds is really, really high. So you must be aware that even if you get 1 liter of a detergent, it's a highly concentrated product. So if you dilute it with water, from the 1 liter you can get 20 or even more liters according to the instruction. So all of the products are concentrated. Because the cleaning compounds are high quality, they can be very easy to wash away. This is especially important with the washing up liquids. So when you wash up the plates and glasses, you have to make sure that all the detergent is easy to be washed out. And here, in this case, you can make sure that it is. And the third point is packaging. First of all, the packaging is durable. It is made of polyethylene. It is easy to recycle, so it is environmentally friendly. There is a low emission of CO2 during the production process. It's impermeable. It means that whatever content it is inside the product, even after 1, 2, or 3 months, the concentration of the detergent is going to be exactly the same. So which products contain nanoparticles which protect the surface? So first of all, the glass cleaner, shower cleaner, bathroom cleaner, ground cleaner, and lime scale and rust remover. So for instance, if you've got a sink or a bath tube and you can see some rust or lime scale, once it's cleaned and you use this product on a regular basis, it is more difficult for the rust or lime scale to accumulate on the surface. So then, you know that the protective layer has been created. One of the top-selling products, based on the sales analysis, are the laundry liquid for colours, the laundry liquid for white, the scaler, Babasu washing up liquid, and the drain cleaner. So I would recommend these products to show your potential customers at first, because then you can make sure that if it's going to work, they will ask for something more. So thank you very much for your attention. One more thing that I'm going to say is that if you would like to attract more people into the business, instead of just giving the catalogs to them and they see the pages and they will give you the catalog back, it is a good idea to lend them the product, especially the household product. Just get 2 or 3 extra products and give to some people with the catalog and tell them, I just wanted to try because I'm doing some research. I'm going to find out how it works. And then later on, I'll get back to you in 2 or 3 days and I'll ask you if you're happy with that. And actually, there's no obligation for you to get it. But I'm sure if they use it, they'll ask you, can I get it? So there are many different ways that you can use in order to attract people to your business. So thank you very much.